Hello everyone, today we will see how to use Replit or how useful it is with respect to the application development course. So let's get started. Now this is the user's dashboard screen, and here on the top left we will be getting this new Replit button here. We will be clicking on it, and here we can actually select a language for which we want to code for, and we can actually select Python here, and we can also name our project. So let's name it as app F1. Okay, now after this we can click on this create Replit button. So after clicking on this, we would have to wait for some small amount of time so that we can actually get an interface like this. So we get a connected message here. That means the Python interpreter has been connected as well. So here it is, the interface has been completely loaded for us, and this actually can be divided into mainly three sections. So on the leftmost side here, this is a layout panel. So this will actually show us a list of all of the files that we are actually using in our project. For now, we only have one file called main.py here. The second section, this is our workspace. We can also call it as our coding workspace, where we are actually supposed to write some code. On the right-hand side here, this is our console, where we will be getting the output for whatever code that we will write here. So since this is a Python project, so let's start with a very simple Python command. Or a simple Python code. Let's say print hello world, and let's see if we will execute this Python code, what will happen. So we can actually execute it by using this run button here on the top. So let me click on it, and here it is. Yes, we are actually getting the output. Okay, that's great. Now, since we are going to use it with respect to the application development course, and we will be required to add a lot of HTML files in the project. So the question here is that, can we add HTML files in a Python project? The answer is absolutely yes. In this layout panel, we are actually being given two buttons, add file and add folder. So if we want to add HTML files, we can click on this add file button, and we have to provide the full name of the file. Full name means you also have to provide the extension of the file. So what will I do is, I will write index, that is actually the name, and dot HTML. That means this is gonna be an HTML file. I'll hit enter and see. This index.html file has now been added in my project. So I would be required to write some HTML code here. So let's get started with the doc type declaration. So this doc type declaration is nothing. It is just an information to the browser that the following HTML code is being written in HTML5, then we will write the HTML root element, then the closing root element. Within that, we are gonna have our head tag, the closing head tag, and within that head tag, we are also gonna have our title. So let's say the title can be my first. Okay, this is fine. We will add the closing title tag, and after that, we can actually add our body tag also. So this is gonna be the closing body tag. Now here we can actually add some content, the main content that is gonna be shown on the output or on the web page or on the browser. So let's write a heading here. Let's say this is my first web page. All right, okay. So now we have added some HTML code here. Now let's see if we will click on this run button, what is gonna happen. So let me click on this run. Okay, so here we are only getting hello world, and this is actually the output for this main.py file. Yes, so if we are actually using a Python project and we are clicking on this run button, so this will only execute the main.py file. This has nothing to do with the new files that you are actually adding in the project. So what we are actually required here is, we have to add some driver code in this main.py file that can trigger our index.html file. So let's do that. I will actually add some code here, and you really don't need to worry about this code, that what this code is and how is being written. This is just a driver code which we are using to trigger this index.html. Now, if we will click on this run button again, so here we are actually gonna get a HTML output. So see, a small web browser window has been opened on the rightmost side of this interface screen, and we are actually getting our HTML output here as well. Okay, so that's great. Now, let's try to add some links in this page, and let's see if we are actually navigate to some other pages as well. So let me do one thing. Let me actually create an anchor tag here. And let's say the href attribute value, it can be acad.html. So acad.html is also a file that we are supposed to add here in this project. For now, I haven't added it. So let's add some text here, go to acad, and then we can close this. All right, so since we have added this anchor tag, we also have to add this acad.html here. So let me add that file as well here. acad.html. All right, I have added it. So instead of writing the whole code again, I'll just copy from here and I'll paste it. But I will remove this anchor tag. And this heading, I am gonna change it to, this is the acad page. All right, this looks fine. Okay, so now we will again reinstantiate this browser screen here. We'll stop it, we will run it again. And yes, we are actually getting our updated HTML page here along with this heading. We are also getting this link here. Let's see what will happen if we will click on this link. So yeah, I clicked on it and I went to a different page, and that is my acad.html page. Okay, great. So that means everything is working here. We can add as many as HTML files in a Python project. So this is actually gonna serve the purpose for us. Okay, all right. So I hope you all enjoyed this introduction video. Thank you. Thank you very much.